Hey, everybody out there on YouTube, this is Cheetawolf. What do you mean low light detection cannot be used, but hey, everybody out there on YouTube, this is Cheetawolf. You may notice this video looks and sounds a little different than usual, primarily because of this freaking stupid video stabilization crap that I should have turned off, and because if you look at it, it's all progressive scan and horrible. Anyway, well, all that aside, I am the new proud owner of this Samsung Galaxy Note 4. A replacement for the subject of today's very, very special episode of On the Workbench. This is the Workbench Portable. This is where electronics go to die, if I particularly hate them. And I hate no other piece of electronics right now more, aside from like the Dell Precision or something, than this. My iPod Touch 5, which has sadly outlived its service life due to a fault, which I will get into more detail on later. That video stabilization really sucks off to... anyway, let's turn it on. Oh, I think I gotta clean my lens or something. That's horrible. Do you see that line going across the screen? Yeah, it's... Hang on, clean my lens. Kind of. Now, I turn the iPod on. It starts up all right. I said, it starts up all right. Oh, right! That's right! The battery's dead, and it refuses to charge. This is exactly the problem I've hit. Let's see here. Today, I bought a brand new cable in the box just for it. And it's a fake cable, but I'm not buying a $30 cable just to blow the thing up with, because spoilers, that's what I'll be doing today. I'll plug... My goodness, it is windy out there! I'm afraid my... Hang on, I'm gonna bring my camera in. I'm afraid it might topple over. Let's bring that in. I don't want this thing to go toppling down. That would really suck. I've already had it happen once in that Salter Park Thunderbolt video. Twisty ties. I'd sing a song here, but then I get sued by Ashens. Let's see what happens when I plug it in. Let's set my phone down on this little case. I found an issue with my phone's case as well. It doesn't let me take video of stuff. Okay, I'll put the phone there. And now I'll plug the iPod in. And look at that, it starts up just as it should. Oh no, jump cuts! But anyway, here is precisely the issue I'm dealing with. Something's up with it. It blinks. It stops charging. Then it starts charging, then it blinks a bit, then it stops charging, then it starts charging. Basically, the battery refuses to charge. So you know what? If 5 volts won't help it, maybe about 50 will. Because what we've got here is... Variac. Switch gear, that lets me switch between AC and DC current. That's a ballast, which I've disabled. That's the DC conversion box. That there, with the fan on it. That's another ballast, which I've also disabled for this. And, yeah, that's it. That's transformer for the contactor and the relays, and yeah. Basically, this iPod's gonna wish it started charging. Because I'm about to force a whole lot more energy than that little USB cable was designed to provide. Now, we will move the camera into position here. Also, I have two other cameras that will be trained on our iPod. I'll have my camera here set up like this. My good camera. The good one. Down there, I'll have an action camera pointed at the ports to see all the smoke come out, and then I have what I'm gonna call my fireball cam over here. So when the thing does go up in flames, I will see it. And that thing is still doing its thing. It's blinking a bit and then turning off again. So that thing is toast, and it will be even more toast very shortly. So stand by for just a second while I change that cable into something we can actually use. Three, two, one, jump cut, go! Jump cut failure! I forgot to be showing what tools I'll be using. I will be using my dollar store destruction kit that I just made today just for this video and for others. Basically, it's a little toolbox from the dollar store filled with tools from the dollar store. I've got screwdrivers, pliers, a multi-screwdriver set with all little bits all in the handle. If I open it without making them flew everywhere, hold on. Come on, open up. With all little power bits in the handle for my drill and stuff, is that. Protective gloves, and of course, wire strippers. They don't even open. Basically, what this thing is... get out of the wind! Basically, what this thing, but the dollar store toolkit says, the dollar store destruction set, if you're a piece of crud like that, you don't deserve to be destroyed by good tools. So I will get back to that in just a second. Low light I don't care! Anyway, also, while this thing's here being dead, I'd just like to point out that my original iPod Touch, despite being much worse for wear and having seen much harder life than this thing lasted about a year, give or take. However, my original iPod Touch 4 is 4 years old and still kicking strong. It still works. What this thing is, this is my entertainment center. The Wi-Fi sensor's been damaged up here, so it won't pick up Wi-Fi anymore. But it's still my entertainment center, and I use it for generating the sounds I sleep to, like this. Good old Thicket Classic, nothing like it. Believe it or not, I sleep to this. I'll upload a 10-minute sample of this, and I'll just put it in the description. Microphone's over here, I gotta keep remembering that. I sleep to that, and with a speaker system under my bed, I can sleep to that without a problem. Cause this thing is still going strong after 4 years. Well, this thing is crapped out after one, so I'm done with Apple, and it's gonna go out with quite the bang. Now, let's actually jump cut to this thing freaking dead. Boy, I gotta say, it sure was a great idea bringing this work light out here, because it got dark quick. Holy crap. Anyway, we are just about ready. Here's the setup. We've got the crapple iPood there. It's about to become iPopped. There's the cable. It goes all the way up, and I've stripped the ends and tapped the variac leads directly into the positive and negative end of the cable through the red and black wires. I've got the variac on and in DC mode. I've got my voltometer and multimeter thing, whatever it is, up here, so I can get the voltage close to 12.5 volts or so. I at least want to give it a chance. Turn the light on. Let's trim that to 5 volts. Why are we not getting power out of that? Oh no, something's wrong with it. Is it set to AC? No, it's DC. What the heck is wrong with this thing? So, let's get our camera started. Start it up. That guy's running. Trained on the screen like the eyes of an eagle and also hawk. Get it? Because my username? Ah, forget it. And this is the fireball cam. Fireball cam is active. I said fireball cam's active. Gotta slick it up. Alright, make sure that's lined up relatively well. Okay, that's actively recording as well. So, get that guy going. Get this guy going. I said get this guy going. There we go. Now, here's our camera orders. Main camera, dead center. Fireball cam, right here. And this camera, sort of in the corner here somewhere. And I will be holding this and recording as well as I dial up the power. So, first things first, let's plug it in. All cameras are confirmed recording. All right, let's get that multi-view now. So, let's plug it in. Put my phone down on its stand. And look at it a little bit over here. There's the device, right there. Now I will plug the cable in and stand the heck back. Voltmeter is reading down to 4.1 volts. The screen hasn't done anything. Let's see if we can get it to wake up a little bit. Polarity's correct. It's not a reverse polarity situation. I got that correct. Let's turn it up a little. You know what? I'll hold the camera as I do this. I don't want my brand new phone to get in danger. I got my two action cameras there, and my camera's way up here, out of the way, zoomed in. So let's see. Also, it says my video's upside down. That's annoying. I'll have to fix that in editing, I guess. Let's just dial up the power. So that's hovering at 4.1 volts. Let's turn it up a little. 4.6. Oh, we're up to 6 volts already. Nothing I can see on the screen yet. And that camera's just cut out. You're kidding, right? Ugh. eBay batteries. Okay, fine. You are the new Fireball cam, or the new frickin' side, whatever, I don't know. You're this new camera. Editing, move the view, go. This is that. Don't smell anything coming out of it yet. Nope, it's still trying to hold on. Let's turn it on, see what happens, see if we get anything out of it. It's trying to do something. Got the logo of stupidness on the screen. Let's turn it up a little more. That's 10 volts. Oh! Is that the screen failing, or is something just... Does it still want to turn on? It says it's getting power! This thing... right now is happily eating 10 volts of power. Although I can't remember if that's the symbol that you need to plug it in or that it's charging. So it could just be freaking out now. I think that's the symbol that it needs to be charged. Let's turn it up a little more. That's exactly 10 volts. 18... 20? I heard something pop in there. Did you hear that? I'm hearing noises. It's making noises. I should probably stand back, because I get the feeling this battery's going to go up in flames. Let's turn it up a little more. That's 20.5. 30 volts. Anything? 40? 45? Screw it, let's turn up all the way. 130 volts DC. Let's reverse our polarity. Oh, I heard some electronic crackling. Now we're at negative 130. I heard a crackling noise. Switch it again. I think something just went very wrong. Oh, great. The police are already here to investigate. I think I just popped the circuit breaker is what I did there. This thing gets extremely temperamental when you switch it around like that. That's fine, let's freaking reset the circuit breaker. I have to do this all the time. I think the breaker itself's getting weak or something. Yep, I popped it. Oops. I just shut off something very important, I think. Something that powered 40 amps. What was that?
Oh, that was just the heater in the bathroom.
Okay, let's go back outside. Go!
It smells blown up. No, I don't. It doesn't smell blown up. Are my connections correct?
I found I could get a better connection if I, like, press down on it. I just don't want to do that while it's running. You know what? Screw that. I don't have to do that while it's running. Is this one even recording? Yes, it is. I don't even have to do that. Because, if I can find it here somewhere... Come on, don't make a liar out of me. Where is it? This is where the trademark messy workbench comes in. You know what? I'll be back when I find it. And we're back! Screw you and your low light detection. Anyway, we're back! And this time, we're not messing around. Let me just plug this back in here so we get our work light back. There we are. We're back in action. All cameras are still recording.
How is that one's battery not died yet? If it'll focus on it. The battery usually dies by now. It's off center a bit now, but...
Now, this time though, I've brought out the heaviest artillery I could get my hands on. If you come over here... You'll see... I ain't screwing around anymore. This will blow it up, no matter what protection's in it, because it'll just jump the gap. Can you see that?
How do you set autofocus? Come on, focus.
Didn't zoom in. Oh, there we go. Gas tube sine transformer. 9,000 volts this thing is. And I'm about to pump every single one of those volts into that iPod. So if the insulation on the wire doesn't give way, something else certainly will. All right, all cameras live. We are, except for that one, but that one's stupid and deserves to probably get blown up next. All systems are go, so let's go. I can't remember if I turned it on first or not. It's got a switch in it. Probably not, but whatever. Come on, plug in.
Cord's all bent.
Come on, plug in.
Fit.
Looks like I haven't turned it on yet. Let me go do that right now. Shut this power off. Now switch the transformer on. And then when we restore power, dead will occur. Dead is not occurring. Why is dead not occurring? Is anything going on? That thing should be completely cooked. Apple, you're kidding me. Are those dots on the... I don't want to touch this thing. I might get zapped by this. Let's try pulling the switch. It won't kill me from this distance, I don't think. Yeah, that energized. I can feel it buzzing. It is energized. It's doing something. How is it not dead yet? You know what? No, I am not standing for this. Okay, if electricity won't destroy it, does the thing still attempt to power up? Does it still try to power up? Nothing. Well, I've blown it up electronically. So, you know what's next? What's next is for me to get my pneumatic tools in here. Try to adjust our camera a little. So clearly, This thing does not want to die. Fortunately for it, though, I have the tools to make it die whether it wants to die or not. Just pull my air hose off of here. My wonderful compressor. Because what I got is definitely going to break this thing. Turn the regulator up here. Maximum pressure. I got one of these. At the very least, I'll drill a hole through this frickin' thing. I'm gonna stop recording with my good phone, because I don't want to get this thing destroyed, so I'll switch to the other views. Alright, so we've got our leaky air shooty gunny thing. And if we can't, we will bore a hole straight through this thing. You're kidding me! This didn't crack, it flew through the case, but it didn't crack the screen! What is this? Look at that! If you can see that, it's taken chunks out of my screen protector, but it hasn't actually cracked the screen. What on earth is this thing made out of? Wipe the screen off. The screen is freaking flawless after that. Does it still try to start? Or has it in fact died horribly? It's still going strong. Let's see how much more this thing can take. There goes the screen! Those screen protectors must really do a lot. One hit, the thing freaking annihilated itself. How's that blown to pieces? Wish I had zoomed in on that. Let's keep boring through it. I smell signs that badness is afoot. I smell that distinct burning lithium battery smell. It's very slight, but it's there. Let's zoom out a bit. That's why I got the fireball cam going. Let's keep going through. Oop. The neighbors must hate me. I've punctured the battery, that's for sure. I can smell it. Where is the battery in this thing? There's like a shield over it. I just noticed there's a SKU number on that. Cool case. Okay, I'm sure I punctured the battery multiple times, but why isn't it blowing up? It's not even warm. That's... Yeah, I smell it. I've cut through the battery. I can smell that smell you make when you cut through the battery. Let's cut through it the other way, right through the Apple logo. Hope Steve Jobs is squirming in his grave. Yeah, I smell it every time I do that. It must be an explosion-proof battery. Let's break its little flash LED. Screen. I think that's enough destruction for now. So here's the screen of it. Crispy. It's got the crisp screen in it. So is that, it's all bendable now. It's glass dust. Smell the cancer. Yeah, the battery wasn't in there. I can't smell it in there. This is probably just like the backlight in there or something. Let's point it up a little more. Light up so we can see it better. So here's what that was. That's the screen. Other screen. Cake's got a little warm. I have bored multiple holes into the driveway, though, if you look down there and see that. I've gone clean through it and bored holes through the driveway. Here's the case. There's the panel thingy for the camera and whatever. But yeah, I will admit, Apple make a tough device. I pumped 9 kilovolts into that thing and then bored through it multiple times with brute force, and the thing did not blow up. Although, again, I can definitely smell some kind of like eggnoggy smell coming from it. Oh, and look at that. The little iPod touch loop thing still works. Let's fix that. I'll show you loops after your frickin' endless charging loop. Yeah, there's that eggnoggy smell. That battery has definitely been damaged. Let's peel it open, see what's inside. Let's drop it. So, although I suppose I did manage to blow it up internally electronically, it was not spectacular. Here's like a piece of the camera or whatever. And I'm pretty certain it is in fact leaking some kind of battery juice out. Yeah. Rattles. So yeah, I'm kind of ashamed it wasn't that spectacular. I suppose, you know, Apple devices are designed to be tough. I didn't think they'd be so tough that they were Cheetawolf resistant, though. Clearly they're not Cheetawolf proof, because this, but then again, not much is Cheetawolf proof. So, yeah. I'm gonna snap a high definition picture with my new phone just to rub it in the old one's face. Now watch this, drop this one and break it. Just to get a couple pictures here. It's getting slightly warm. I fear the battery may be about to explode in my hands. Let's just get another picture of that. Yep, the neighbors have in fact brought the dog out. You know what? Let's put all the little bits together. And we'll take one big group photo. This thing takes 16 megapixel photos. I'll have to splice that into the video. Let's flip it over. Flip the other bits over as well, other screen parts. And yeah, I'm genuinely sad that it didn't go better than this, guys. I've done all I can do. Okay, I haven't done quite all I can do yet. Bend it in half. I won't even do that. Yeah, it's got that eggnoggy smell. Peel back this metal part. Yeah, the battery is under there. There's the battery. You know what, let's go for a corner of the battery, because I know that bit's still intact. Yeah, I've cut through the battery, and now the neighbor's dog's... Oh, for crying out loud. Freaking neighbor's dogs that they let out as I'm destroying something and recording a video. Yeah, if you look there, if you can see that, I've punctured the battery. So, I guess it's one of the stupid safe batteries. Well, iPod, it's been a good year. You worked with me reliably till the bitter end. Well, actually, a little bit before the bitter end. You know what? Maybe if I put the case back on it. Put the screen protector part on. And then put this on, which is leaking liquid crystal juice. There we go, good as new. Let's get a new one under warranty so we can blow that one up as well. Frickin' crapple.